hell.
Do you get that?
Show last night, Glasgow, yeah, fucking rocking. good at this candid shit, you know, like just the camera being there, natural. It's like, I just blend. I don't know it's there, I just do my shit, I don't act up to it. Just, I don't know it's there. So a lot of the shit you're gonna get from me is like, I just don't know it's there, just be my natural like, environment, just fucking around. So just blend, do your shit, I won't know you're there, I'll just carry on, you know, and we'll just bust it together, right?
Alright, with the Prodigy, we're running a competition on Daily Motion for you guys to make your own video to our track Run With The Wolves.
You can download the track on the link below.
And then when you when you've done that, make a badass video, you win $3,000, and you've got to upload your video to Prodigy Group, and another address should be appearing here.
Right now.
I don't know what it is, but read it, upload it, we'll judge it. You become world famous music director.
Next Scorsese film.
You get $3,000, and we get a good video.
Just coming up to 10 to 4 Tuesday afternoon. This is James playing Just Great Songs on South End Radio 105.1. I'm sure you can't wait tonight to go to the Cliffs Pavilion if you've got tickets to go and see the Prodigy. Their much anticipated comeback back to their home county of Essex, and the show tonight part of the Run With The Wolves tour. Enjoy tonight if you are going along. I'm sure it's going to be an absolutely fantastic gig.
We're in
South End.
South End. It's going to be good. It's going to be loads of old faces out there, you know.
It's going to be quite
yeah, the old school.
I don't find it any different from doing any big venues. You know what I mean? I find it more buzzy doing small venues. You know, just the intensity and just the darkness of the clubs. Just love it.
Like, we always get requests from people wanting it to come down to, like, you know, sort of Devon and stuff like that. That kind of part of England. So like we did Plymouth last night, didn't we? That was good. We've played down that area for ages, you know. I mean, it's obviously a bit more intense than when you do the arena tour, you know. But yeah, I mean, when we did Blackpool the other day, my understanding, well, I thought it was going to be like 1,500 capacities, and it was like 3,500. The form was like 6,000. So they look small.
This is probably the smallest one, which is like 2,300. So this is the smallest out of all of them.
We're not playing. It's not like we're playing in the Wild West. You know, it's like bands we come here, but it's just kind of like, I guess when most bands when they're on like doing arena tours or whatever, they kind of tend to miss out the in between dates.
Yeah, we stick to the major cities, yeah. Birmingham, Manchester, so forth. And forget about the surrounding areas. So
it's just a bit more intense, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. A little bit out of town as well, you know, like away from the usual beaten track that everyone seems to do the same sort of gigs in the same sort of town. So I think it was like a little bit of a swerve to kind of, you know, go to the areas where, you know, maybe most bands don't normally go to, and, you know, give a chance to the, you know, different audience get in touch with the band, you know. This is like what, you know, this is like what you almost hear the heartbeat of the building right here. This is the nerve centre, really. I mean, just cast your eye around here. It says it all. It says everything about the venue itself. You know, all the fucking greats have been here. And if you haven't, if you're going to cut your teeth and you're going to get out there and make it, you play here. I mean, I'll just take you through it. Ooh, ooh, I love you. This is Alvin Stardust. I mean, the man just brought back the leather glove. I mean, like no one else. You've got the Chuckle Brothers here. I mean, they are prime time performers. You know, set the precedent for slapstick in our modern times. There's them doing Dick Whittington there, and that was a very compelling. It's a really sort of cooked it up and brought it back into the 20th century. You've got Ken Dodd. Yeah, I mean, all the greats. I mean, just if you just put your eye around there and building up a big picture of Brian Connolly. I mean, what that guy hasn't done. I mean, Connolly essentially is the new Forsyth. That's a stage call there. As we're on in 10 minutes. There's no messing around here. These guys are by the book. You don't fuck around. That alarm goes. You get your shit on, you get on, and you rock it, and you get the fuck out. And that's how it is. The what can only be described as the heartbeat of the venue.
Right on the end of your belly. This is pure comedy, you know, I mean, just got
teeth.
Yeah, with teeth. But like, just the front teeth.
Oh my God!
she bit my friend. Just go. If she's ugly, she's ugly. This girl fucking bit me in the kid and spit out. And after I smacked her over the head.
But what about the prodigy gig?
The prodigy was fantastic. I love it.
Cotterole is about to make some more work on this tattoo here and finish off the job we started at Christmas. And yeah, we're well up for it. We're buzzing. Let's go.
I'm earning it. That's okay, it's cool. It's quite a sore point in there, man. It's, you know. Hey, it is what it is.
See, chop the blood coming.
Chop the blood.
Because.
Yeah, it's very close to bone.
Yeah, very close. But it's cool, it's easy. Today is easy. Yeah, man.
You did here.
Yeah, too. Anchor. Here.
Wow.
And they both again.
Yes,
this
yes,
and this
yes.
Again. So all of this today.
Wow.
Yeah, man, I'm loving it.
Mm.
I like the strength of it from here. Bang! Cotterole was here. Yeah.
Where the fuck are you? I said, where are you?
Reckon, am I showing off? Ice. I mean, what do you reckon? Is it a bit big?
It's a bit 50 cent.
summer, sorry.
Yeah. 쓰 게 갖고 갔다. 쓰 게 갖고 갔다. 사이코!
Stop following me, man!
Liverpool banging. Yeah, so first we're going to play their law. And then we're going to play Breathe. And then we're going to play Worlds on Fire.
We've got this thing called Beat 55 in the middle.
We're going to play Spitfire.
We got we got Warriors Dance.
Firestar, everybody knows what it's gonna be like then.
Action Radar, that's a link. Warning.
And then we're gonna play Mescaline.
Voodoo.
Yeah, for our encore, we're gonna play Poison. Smack my bitch up.
Yeah, it should be a good night. Should be alright. Well, let's see. You know.
Fire!
things to do at the bus stop.
We'll be right back. Is upon us. I have the shits, diarrhea, athlete's foot, I have a cold sore coming, a sty, and other ailments, some of them viral and other of them anal. Piles, bleeding colon, and growing toenail. It's good to be back.
Germany, Rock and Ring, going on stage in the light tonight, which is something that I don't personally like doing. We've got a few daylight gigs this year. We're going on before Slipknot.
Slipknot, motherfucker!
it's gonna be metal. The metal crowd. This is also this venue is the German Grand Prix circuit. So basically, you're playing in the middle of the racetrack, which is it's pretty fucking cool, really.
I wanted to say to you,
yeah.
You know, Rob plays the guitar and all that, but I'm sure I can play it a bit better.
Go on.
You reckon I could do a tune?
Yeah, go on.
Fuck the fucking law! All my people here! Fuck the fucking law!
I'm sure I can do it on their law, man. Better than Rob.
One more than 10.
Drummer does look good.
Amazing.
Amazing. I mean,
it's got such a rhythm.
Good rhythm. Amazing tattoos.
Timing.
Hairdo. Talent. And apparently.
Blonde.
Yeah. Amazing in bed. But the thing is, I spoke to the guys yesterday, and they said he was so cool to hang out with.
Really?
Yeah, it was like having, you know, like someone that he'd grown
drink,
up with.
Drink buddy.
Drinking buddy.
Party buddy.
Yeah, he wanted to hang out because they've been touring up apparently for a while. And they said, look, if you're, I didn't want to, it was like...
No, is that you? Maxim's got on Black Sabbath's bus by mistake.
Is that a bus there?
You hang out from there. We hang out with all the biggest bands in Germany.
All the cutting edge bands.
USA.
Glastonbury, yeah, we're here at Glastonbury. I like Glastonbury. I didn't, but I like it now. Just come in here, passing Stonehenge. You get the vibe, you really feel a vibe when you drive through the festival. I wish I kind of came a bit earlier to enjoy it. But I'm here now, I'm going to rock it.
Glastonbury soundbite. Well, I was at the front of the stage 10 o'clock this morning. Arrived yesterday. And basically, you know, wandering around, it's not an ego thing, but a lot of people buzzing, really cool kids just buzzing for the show, you know, you feel their energy, and that definitely is them, you know, that definitely, that gets you ready for it, you know, you think, oh, I'm responsible for this, I'm not going to let anyone down, you know, and we're all staying, we're all buzzing for it, and yeah, it's special, isn't it, Glastonbury, you know, you feel a certain responsibility, you're closing the show, people don't want to go home thinking that, you know, you just wandered around aimlessly doing fuck all, you've got to go there and bang it for them and make it really special, so, for me, that's what's going to happen, you know, I've got that kind of, special kind of energy, you know, that sets them certain gigs apart from the others. Listen, they're all special and everyone knows that. There's never a slack Prodigy gig. Yeah, I'm uploading. Mon dieu, abaisit, l'on ponte les pontes des fois, les cinquante-trois, on ponte fer, les consommer. Les ponts, les souhaits par sélection, les fers, les trois fois, le crème, mes six copains, dont zoomer, les ponts des bécons, et vous y voir, et des pouces, mon ton père, du want, le monde guise, magnifiquement, quel est pas, que nous. Where the mark is quest to Mr. Gazo. To produce your John. This is the band of Glastonbury.
Listen, 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 listen! Listen! I want to see every fucker jumping! Every fucker jumping!
Yeah, we're going on stage for 10 minutes. I don't know about that couple of drinks, though. Nothing to worry about, like.
Glastonbury!
It's all in Uncle H's hands.
Bring me the poison! You! Yeah! Ah! I'm the poison! Yes, test to the dozen! Come by the fuck, come on! Let me hear you! I got the poison! I got the remedy! I got...
Wigwam.
We're just staying in one.
You know, sleeping in one, 3 nights in a wigwam.
No.
Yeah, making fires, covered in mud. Talking about Leroy. No, in a teepee up in the greenfield.
That would never happen in a million years.
No, that's true, it's fact. He had mud on him. He had dirty fingernails.
First point I've ever, Leroy's never had any mud on him.
No. He asked me for a nail brush.
A nail brush?
Yeah.
I got the remedy. I got it. Can I hear ya? I got the poison to make a remedy. I got the poison. I got the remedy. I got the poison to make me good. I got the. You got the. We'll be right back.
status quo. I mean, quite obviously, the quo lends itself to the ace. So you walk up here. Best ace in music you can get. Status quo.
Don't charge me for treason. Yes, I've got the. Got the poison, got the remedy, got the pulsating rhythmic rhythm. I got the energy, got the venom, got the pulsating rhythmic rhythm. Like people that had, like, you know, like them barbecue type four poster awning things,
yeah.
The people who threw them and onto the tents.
No.
Yeah, five fucking miles.
Just like that. Yeah?
You
ready?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Is it a pair?
Really loves me, that boy.
Leave me the socks.
That's what breaks bands up, that sort of shit there. A man gets a pair of socks, one of the band members. That's the shit that shatters bands into a million pieces.
Your tour manager.
Yeah.
Fans, alright. Tour manager.
I live, breathe, shit, sleep with this guy here, and he's got.
Keith Flint pants.
Yeah. But I'm on his ass. But I'm gonna have to tase ya. I'm gonna have to sanitize ya. Back.
Hello, is it me you're looking for? I've been waiting for your call. I've been waiting for your call. I've been waiting for your call. You can speak to me now.
When you've left your message, just hang up, or for more options, press 1 at any time.
See you. Yeah, see ya. you're looking for. I've been waiting for your call.
Negative. I was like, we could do this. Look, he wanted to
do
4 days.
For a minute.
I said, look, do 2 weeks. We'll get on a bus. He goes, oh yeah, we've got to get flights and hotels. Fuck the flights and hotels, man.
Yeah,
I said, just get on
a
bus.
I'll
bring my sleeping bag, bring my comfort blanket, you know, a couple of toys and all that shit.
So
a bit of lavender for the pillow.
We'll do it.
Here we are.
I said, listen. I said, fucking listen.
You know, like, you know, people could talk about going to see a band that's had a good reputation for being live or being thumping or, you know, like, it's, you know, a cool band. And you go and see them and you go, what was it like when they were spanking it? Well, if you was at the show last night, you would have seen Prodigy at its best ever. Ever.
This is the reason I hate tour bus, because I'm asleep like that. Every time you go in the corner, it's like, every 10 minutes,
yeah.
I'm like, ah, fucking hell.
Underbroke man.
How do you find travelling by bus rather than hotel?
I love it. I love it, you know, the sort of setting up camp and being driven around in your, as a little gang. Like last night, sitting up watching little Richard Price, all laughing together, you know what I mean? It's all part of the camaraderie and whatever you want to call it. So,
I think one is you wake up and you're where you got to go, rather than, especially in the days when you used to have the real bad hangovers and you'd be up all night, and then you'd look, you know, I've got 2 hours and I've got to be at the airport, and there's no airport that runs smoothly or that's just in and out, is there? So with this, you just roll on, roll off, you're there. Yeah, I love it. Especially when you have a really good driver. Cute, really good driver. We have a caption with that Douglas, please. Really good driver.
Why is that?
Take this way.
Thank you, that was great.
Where are you going now?
Going back to bed.
It's in two women's shows.
Really?
Yeah. It's to pay for it.
Yeah.
The next album's called I Love Flowers.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. And we're going to be changing the name of the band.
It's going to be the darkest album you've ever heard.
Yeah! 20 years, we've managed to save up and get one of these. We've managed to fit that in our wardrobe case.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're getting there.
Fucking mental, buzzing away. Just us, them, and the fucking music. Bam.
Thank you!
Download.
That was awesome.
I don't know. Am I wearing the wrong top? I know. I mean, I'm not. I sort of never dress for the occasion. That's for sure. Neither do I think that. I mean, I'm happy, but I don't know. I'm looking around. I'm not. It seems a little bit dark. Guy handed me a broom and told me to get on with my fucking work. We've got to just avoid these light pleasure craft here.
Giving a go at it?
Yeah. Yeah. We're just avoiding these very light pleasure craft.
What's that
phone there? Turn! I can't hear you!
Let's rock!
Where the fuck are you now? Where are my people now? Where's the sound, man? You know the score. Turn the fucking sound up. All my people in Donington. It's your fucking time. Wait for it. Wait fucking for it. Here it fucking comes. Are you ready? Are you ready? Woo! We'll be right back.
Carr, Dougie, Ronnie, Sammy, Whistler Jim, Legs McAndrew, Gingy Rob, and Long John, Johnny John from Johnford. You never get there, and I said, my boys are over there, and they mean it. And I'm going, hell or high water. I said, reel it, yeah, go ahead, man. I said, reel in the crab lines, boys. We're going in.
We'll be right back.
So you want to know, you must want to know where we are. That's Ibiza. I mean, but Ibiza for me, it's, you know, it's got a lot of history, and we did one gig in 94, and that's my whole experience of Ibiza. Yeah, I just remember getting a bit messy and wandering around and trying to sort of suck it up, but, you know, look, it's banging out there, you know, that's what it's all about, so, you know, it's kind of like stealing candy from a baby. You know, you go out there and it's going to just fucking be mental. Yeah, as I say, I mean, it's, you know, everyone knows what Ibiza is about, so it's not this, you know. There's no hiding the fact that they're all off their nuts and fucking, you know, bang up for it. You know, the Prodigy Mayhem will build on that and definitely cause a riot. So yeah, I've been for Rocks, that's about 2000 I think. And Saturday night, Milton Keynes Bowl, that will be 65,000. So, usual Prodigy flipping it on its head from small, intimate, banging, hot to big and in your face. Milton Keynes is going to be. It's going to be the biggest solo gig we've done, you know, because obviously we're putting that on ourselves. It's going to be the Warriors Dance Festival, which is something that we've kind of, we started off in Japan, and yeah, you know, it really matters, as does every gig, but now I think the magnitude of it has really sort of dawned on us, and it's made us really step up, as I say, with rewrites, remixes, and bringing back some tracks that, you know, people want to hear. And as I say, we certainly haven't been, we're never lazy, but we certainly haven't been lazy this time. I said to Liam the other day, he's almost spent as much time in the studio that he may have spent writing a quarter of the album before, so it's, you know, a lot of work, but all I want to get across is, this is going to be a fucking super thumping show, and we've put a lot of work in it, and we're buzzing for it.
Prodigy here, sending a message to our fans, our Russian fans, to let them know that tonight's show in Moscow has been cancelled due to the stage collapsing. The team, promoter, everyone has tried to get the stage rebuilt overnight, and it isn't happening. So we're unable to play.
We discovered, like, when we landed basically late last night, that the night before the gig, that the whole left-hand side of the stage had just collapsed into the audience. I think the PA, the speakers and the whole of the left-hand side had just basically fallen in. And to be honest, it was lucky that it happened then, really. Do you know what I mean? And not during the gig, because it would have been...
Yeah, if people were there, it would have been, like, bad. Out of control. You know, it's just... So...
That subsequently made the stage totally unsafe.
But, you know, on a show this big, with something so massive going wrong, it just couldn't be fixed. Yeah. All of our team, all of the people involved with, like, making our shows happen, went straight on site. They took everyone that... Everyone, the sound man, the guys that you know, are usually building the stage on our behalf, and there was nothing that could be done. They stayed there through the night. You know, I think they left 3-4 this morning trying to make things happen. They went to look at other venues to see if it could be moved somewhere else. That just couldn't happen. You can't set a gig up in 12 hours. You know, it just doesn't happen. So
we're upset, you know.
Yeah,
we're upset that we can't do the gig. Like the guys are saying, do you know what I mean? We like to perform wherever we go. We like to fulfil our commitments, do you know what I mean?
True.
And play to our fans, and you know, we're gutted as well that we can't play.
Thank you.
Peace, and we'll see you next time. The Prodigy will be back in Russia. We'll be playing in Moscow, and next time it will be going on, because we will make sure of that. So we will be back. Respect. Peace.
Play Imagine, like,
yeah.
Back to back.
I think once a year Yoko comes here and just sort of lays down some sort of white roses and shit.
Yeah, we were buzzing, you know. It felt really triumphant for us, just finishing it and making a record we're really proud of, because usually I do kind of tend to tear it apart once it's done, sort of start analysing it. But, you know, I think with this one, we knew we got something that we felt would definitely work live, and that's all we'd ever try and do.
I think it was something we had to prove to ourselves, that we could still do the tunes. For me, it's kind of once the album was mastered and I had that CD in my hand, and I put it in the car and I heard those tunes, man, I was just like, yeah, let's take this on the road. And last year we did 115 gigs, 30 countries, just taking that album around and seeing the response from it. That was obviously the buzz coming back off it. It was just amazing.
I think it was unfinished business, because the last record, it was kind of viewed as maybe more of a solo album, which I understand, you know, it was a confusing record, always outnumbered. And so I think we had unfinished business, really, between the three of us. So it was important to make a band record with this one. To keep it fresh for ourselves, I'm always trying to do little bits and pieces to the tunes, just so it's interesting for us. Take Me to the Hospital, when I wrote that, we just knew it was going to work live. Invaders, first time we played that didn't really work. It was great for the record, but I went back into the studio and just chopped it up and come out with a different version.
The set has to change, or else we'd get bored of doing the same thing. We're not a band that just go on stage and just go through the routine. This band's about buzz, and buzz starts with us.
My name's Jackie Inskip. I'm the general manager for Destination Milton Keynes, which is the independent provider of tourism services for Milton Keynes and the surrounding area. There are lots of activities for people to do in Milton Keynes for all ages, so including things like ballroom dancing, salsa dancing, and over the last couple of years, the Centre MK have been running a tea dance in Middleton Hall, which has proved extremely popular. There are many activities that you can do in Milton Keynes. One of those would be life drawing at Artworks at Great Linford, which in itself is a beautiful setting. It's actually a medieval setting in the grounds of Great Linford Manor, close to the Grand Union Canal, so very peaceful, very inducive for artistic creation. For that, you have an actual nude model posing, and the people who are practicing drawing then try to capture that person on paper. We have a fantastic library service in Milton Keynes. It doesn't just cover the central library here in the city centre, but there are branch libraries right across the area. So you can go to the libraries and borrow not only ordinary books, but you can borrow sheet music, you can borrow CDs, you can borrow cassettes, and you can borrow music books too. So a fantastic service available. This weekend, which is the first weekend in May, we have the garden show taking place at the National Bowl. And then the next big event will be the Prodigy concert on the 24th of July. I think the behaviour of young people generally is very good. There have been a few instances where people have had a bit too much to drink, but you don't actually see them wandering around the streets. They would probably be wandering outside the bars, either at Escape or the Theatre District, but not in great numbers. It's a-